Hey everybody, today I'm going to do a video on my 5.1 home theater system by Polk Audio, the RM6750. It's a six-piece 5.1 home theater system. So you'll get the regular speakers, two fronts, two rears, one center, and a sub. Each speaker can handle within 20 to 100 watts. The sub can handle between 50 to 100 watts. But today I don't have the sub plugged in because I don't really like how the way it works. It seems to bottom out and stuff. So I just have my regular sub there, the clips. And I have the Polk Audio sub on the side just to show you what it's like. So yeah, here's the center, and then here's the front. The front and the rears are pretty much the same. The speakers all have a power port, a vented power port in the back. I've got everything hooked up to the same receiver, a Denon AVR 589. It's pushing out 75 watts per channel. Today I'm gonna be playing like a G6 by Far East Movement, but it's the instrumental with the hook. Same thing through my PS3 and everything. Okay, so here, I'll show you the sub. So that's the sub right there. Here's the back. Let's see, left and right, in speaker level output, right and left, phase auto on, volume low pass, AC. All right, let me take off the front cover to show you what the sub looks like. Let's see. There it is. And it's vented right there at the bottom. Like I said, I'm not using it 'cause it seems to bottom out, and I don't know. It just seems kind of weird. So, I'm just gonna go with that. Okay, so let me just get the song started. Let me turn it up a bit. Negative 38. I'll turn a bit higher. Negative 32 now. Alright, I'm gonna turn it back down. So I went up to negative 32. Sounds good enough. I'm not gonna blast or anything. This system does very well with music and movies. Unlike the Sony, the SAF1TH, I believe, the flat one that I have. It does all right with movies, not so great with music. But the sub does seem to perform better than the Polk Audio sub. Maybe this Polk Audio sub has a problem because I did buy the system as a return item at Fry's. But yeah, the speakers perform really fine. Just the sub, I'm, kind of upset about, but it's all right. I got extra ones. Yeah, that's pretty much it about this system. I just checked their website. They're selling it for $5.99 per unit. Well, I don't know. They're still selling it actually, but that's the price. Fry usually sells it for, I think, 200 brand new. Not sure. Not sure if it's discontinued yet or not. Let's see. These speakers are—they're actually—they have a nice weight on them. Center is about 5 pounds. I'll show you the rear. Just regular terminals, and then you got your power ports right here. Each front and rear has one of those power ports. And yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say. If you got any questions, let me know. All right, thanks for watching.